I just want to thank everybody for being here. Welcome to the Magic Show. If you haven't been welcomed already, my name is David Bryson, and the title of this presentation is I Just Bought My Business, Now What? So just want to make sure everybody's in the right place. If you're looking for the gluten-free baking workshop, that's down the hall. But this is I Just Bought My Business, Now What? So just so I can get to know you a little better, who has owned a business less than 6 months? Okay, 6 months to a year. And over a year. Okay, great. And then one more series of questions for you. Who owns strictly brick and mortar? Who owns e-commerce? And who owns a combination of both? Okay, great. That'll help me know where to go in my presentation with a little more clarity. And so what we're going to do today is talk about some of the roadblocks or the hurdles that people encounter when starting out a business, because it can be overwhelming. So the purpose of this is to make you feel that you're not alone, give you a few edges on the diamond, and give you some ideas and some actionable takeaways that are going to help you grow your business as the days go by. So did anybody feel like that the moment they signed on the dotted line and bought their business? I know I did. Or on some days when it got a little further, that's really what it felt like at its core. Because it just seems like there's so much knowledge coming at you, so many people who want a piece of you, that it does feel absolutely overwhelming. So here's what we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about staying motivated through every challenge. And a great way to do that is to have a vision for your company. And I'm going to drill down on that. Next thing we're going to speak about is your personal strengths and weaknesses and those of your team, if you're sort of scaling up a team to work with you. We're going to talk about if you bought an existing business versus if you started one from the ground up. These growth strategies for those can be different. Some of them overlap, some of them don't, but we really want to focus on that. We want to talk about for budgeting for what counts in marketing and advertising, because there's so many people that are coming at you that want you to spend dollars. So we're going to try to help narrow that nozzle just a little bit so we know where some good places to spend our money. And then to me, the cornerstone of running a great business is giving great customer service. And we're going to talk about it at the end. Then we're going to have some questions and answers. So who here got into their business because, for lack of a better word, they said, I have a passion for fashion or retail? Show of hands. Right. So you get into it because it's something you love and you're really passionate about. And then what happens? You buy the business, and this is what it turns out to be. I didn't know I had to do accounting, bookkeeping. I got to put up my own website. I need to call a lawyer to make sure that contract looks good. I got to do the marketing, the SEO, the social media. Should I blog? Should I podcast? Should I have a vlog? What's going to help me grow my business? Then I got to do sales on top of it, try to do some networking, maybe educate myself. I'm the person in charge of hiring and firing all these people. Got to do the buying, and I got to have a great product assortment. So as you can see, it seems like quickly our passion can get diluted just a little bit. So I want to talk about having a good vision for your company. Who recognizes this? Anyone? What is it? It's a typewriter. So we really don't use these much anymore, do we? This is by a company actually called Smith Corona. If anybody knows anything about Smith Corona, they were a company founded in, I think it was the 1880s, two different guys, they joined together. And what happened was probably by the 1950s, they got into making typewriters. And their stated mission or vision was to be the world's number one typewriter maker. And they actually were. Their sales were on par with IBM. They were innovative. They were coming out with new cartridges. Does anybody know where Smith Corona is today? They make something called thermal imaging paper. I don't even know what that is. But I can assure you, it's not a typewriter. So if we look at essence, what a typewriter is, what is it? It's a way to communicate. I have some thoughts in my head. Type them out, print them out. I can hand them to Peyton, and she can be like, oh, I get what David's thinking. I understand what he's trying to say. And in essence, isn't that what we do with texting today? It's just a different device. We're using our thumbs now, but I'm still communicating with people. So what if Smith Corona's vision had been different? What if they had said, our vision is to create a device that helps us communicate with people from now to infinity? Maybe they'd still be there today, and maybe they wouldn't be making thermal imaging paper. maybe we'd all be texting each other on a Smith Corona. Let's say in the 80s, they had got into word processing, maybe teamed up with AOL in the 90s and said, hey, we're going to help you on that little messenger device you have, and we're going to work through that to create a better way to communicate. Because communication hasn't changed, just the method by which we do it has. So that is Smith Corona. Another company I want to talk about is Coca-Cola. Think about the vision of Coca-Cola. I love Coca-Cola, but what is Coca-Cola in its essence? It's a caramel, sugary, carbonated beverage that I know really isn't that good for me, right? But is that what I think about when I go to drink one? Absolutely not. Because they have done such a good job of associating something else with Coca-Cola. Have a Coke and a smile. Share a Coke with my friend. It has his name on the bottle. There's some dancing polar bears at Christmas time. They have associated such a good thing with their product that I could probably buy dish soap from them and it would still taste good. I'm like, that's a good Coca-Cola. So my question to you is, do you have a vision for your company that is bigger than today? Because if you sit here and say, hey, I just got it into business because I want to make money, making money is a good thing, as we're going to talk about, but it might not get you through the challenges, the hurdles, the innovations that come that Smith Corona could not adapt for. So make sure you have a clearly articulated vision. I highly encourage you, when you get back from Las Vegas, take 10, 15, 30 minutes. Go write down, what is the vision, what is the mission of my store, of my website? Because you are the curator of that vision. When people go to your website, when people go into your store, they're gonna associate something with it, good or bad, and ultimately, you're responsible for that. Think about it. I walk into your store, I look up, I see a bunch of cobwebs. Instead of looking at your great assortment, your great customer service, and your great location, I could be like, wow, this place is really dirty. And what am I gonna do? I'm gonna tell my friends on Yelp they got a dirty store and I'm gonna forget everything else. So you are the curator of that vision. Now let's start talking about how we can maximize our strengths and minimize our weaknesses. And everybody remember this quote from Clint Eastwood from a movie from years ago where he goes, a man's got to know his limitations. Nothing is more true than when you are an entrepreneur. You have to know your limitations. Because like I showed that list before, we get into business because we have a passion for a specified field, but we got to do all this too, and that might not be our passion. So to some extent, we need to be able to do those things on a daily basis. For instance, I hate accounting. Drives me up the wall, bookkeeping, anything to do like that. But I want to know how my business is doing. I want a handle on it. I don't want to wash my hands of what's going on money-wise. So I do have to have some sort of passion for it. But I also know my limitations is that I hire a QuickBooks coach to help me on the phone to do my monthly bank reconciliation. So know where you're going and know what you're good at. And when you can start scaling, think about bringing in specialists. We're all familiar with the Navy SEALs, and they've been in the news a lot lately for good reasons. But I don't know if you know this, the Navy SEALs are divided into four-man teams. Each guy has a different specialty. One guy could be a sniper, another guy could be a demolitions expert, somebody could be a medic, and somebody could be the communications expert. And why is that? So if they go out on a mission and they have to take down somebody from 300 yards, if you have four snipers, you might think that could work out really well. They'll hone in on them. But let's say the mission changes and now they got to go into the city, open the door, and one of the guys gets injured on the way. That's why you want the demolitions guy, and that's why you want the medic. So start thinking about that as you scale your team. Because the person who does your SEO might not be the person who does your social media, might not be the person who does your sales forecasting. And when you're starting out, I know finances can be tough, and that's why you can go to places like Upwork, Fiverr, find a specialist just for a couple minutes to help you out with the season that you are going through. Another thing that I really believe in maximizing my strengths and weaknesses is to do daily personal development. I like to say we live in the transparent age. And you know, we have gurus like Marie Forleo and Tony Robbins, and they want to sell you their stuff, which is great, because that means they put out a lot of free content on the internet that I can listen to and then I can learn from. So when I'm stuck in the back office doing the accounting and the bookkeeping things that I'm not necessarily a fan of, I put on one of them. And you know what it's going to do? It's going to put a new edge